Hare Krishna, discuss why devotees they suffer, they are not happy as though they are in this moment. This is the topic. Why? Can anyone tell that he is happy, he is not suffering anyway because he is in ISKCON moment, so he is not suffering. He is Krishna conscious. Is there anyone? Can rise? Everyone is suffering? Everyone has problems? Everybody has dissatisfaction? But no one. So what could be the reason? The Tamil translation is on 107.5 megahertz. Very, very important. Yesterday only I told that, yesterday class, preacher, guru or anyone, they always go against the will of disciples, audience and all. Yesterday class, I was speaking that one. Many people, they don't like even preacher's advice, guru's advice. Because that is not very heavy. That is against their will. That is the good guru. Guru means heavy. He should be heavy. Now I understood that you are all suffering. You are not free from any problem. Isn't it? So what could be the reason? Can anyone tell? If you know the reason, you could mend your activities. What could be the reason? Can you not guess at least? Why the karma? Karma is according to your activities. You do good karma, you will never suffer. That is within your hand. Yes?
Good karma.
Why? That is the thing. You have to mend yourself. You rectify yourself. You change your desire. Yes. The main point, how you are not having good desires. You raise your hand now.
So the devotee is not, because he is not devoted fully.
So what? What could be the reason? Why he is not fully devoted? What could be the reason?
The faith is not 100% faith.
So what could be the reason for that?
He is not seeing the hidden hand of Krishna.
That is too much problem. Simple way. Yes.
Not chanting properly.
As we know, Yavarti, but why you don't chant very nicely?
Krishna wants to check his sincerity.
Why don't you become sincere? Normally, why? What could be the thing? Without your knowledge, you are doing something. That's the thing you should understand. That you should, I want to, that thing, huh? Without our knowledge, huh? We are doing something.
Offenses.
Huh?
Aparadam.
Offenses. That is very, very correct. All the devotees, there are offending other devotees. Very first offense, what is that one?
Blaspheme.
Blaspheme the devotees who are dedicated? The lives. Whether they dedicated or not, that we do not know. Isn't it? But for their aim is to dedicate everything for the pleasure of Krishna, and they are devotees. But we are offending them. In which way we are offending?
Finding
faults with them. Why we are finding faults with them? Why we are finding faults with them? Why you cannot understand that, okay, his character is like that one. Let him do something. Why we are not like that one? Why we are offending? Why we are offending? We are
envious.
We are envious of other devotees. Why not me? Why he should? Why not me? So this is very, very dangerous character. Which one? Envy. No one can envy anyone. Envy means what? Why we are envying others? Why we develop envy with others? What could be the reason for that? We don't have something which the other person has. No, he has. Isn't it? So normally we become envious of that person who possesses something extraordinary thing which we don't have. So this is the gift given to him by Krishna. If we become envious of that person, then become envious of, then we are envious of Krishna. Please understand, we are not understanding Krishna. Krishna consciousness we are not understanding. Now you can consider two residents are there. Two homes are there. In one home, a devotee is living. In another home, non-devotee is living. Both are doing mistakes, same mistakes. Who will suffer more? Or both will suffer the same level?
Devotees?
Devotees suffer more. Why? They are devotees. They have knowledge. So they do mistake. Having knowledge, they do mistake. Then that is not knowledge. Isn't it? Knowledge means he should be careful. He is not intelligent. He is a fool. Why you are telling he got knowledge? One who possesses knowledge and not utilizing that one properly is not a knowledge person, he is a fool, number one. Having knowledge, behaving unfavorably. So that knowledge is not real knowledge, that is foolishness. Isn't it? Mayaya apakruta jnana. That knowledge is stolen by Maya Devi. Most of us, please remember this story of two friends. One friend goes to temple, another friend goes to prostitute. Prostitute here nothing but material world. Any action that we are doing in this material world is nothing but the action in prostitution, brothel house. In brothel house, they do everything for their own pleasure. In temple, they are supposed to do for the pleasure of Krishna. Okay? The friend goes to temple very nicely, everybody witnessing is daily going to temple and thinking how nicely his friend is enjoying in the material world. Am I correct? The friend who is going to the material world for material activities to enjoy himself, he is thinking, what a fortunate fellow my friend is. I am so unfortunate. He is going to temple. I am unable to go to temple. Is correct or not? No response? You are not understanding or not? So the person going to temple and thinking of material activities, then he is going to, who is coming to him? Servants of Yamaraja. He is going to hellish planet. And the person who is in the material world is going to Vaikuntha Loka. So please understand, many people you come here and we are offending. If you neglect a Vaishnava, you have to face lot of problems. In Krishna consciousness, words are not important. Actions are important. To begin with, words are important. Where there is no action. Please understand, in Krishna consciousness, to begin with, there are no actions, but words are there. After you hearing properly, there is no words, there is action. You understand? To begin with, hearing. That is, taking instructions from Guru. Then you are acting accordingly. Isn't it? This is the thing. Acquiring knowledge is hearing from Guru. Putting them into action. That is for somebody is telling. For realization. One who is not adopting that through the actions, he cannot realize. There are so many people, so-called devotees, not having any realization. They do speak only. They don't realize. What about Prabhupada? Prabhupada is a speaker or is a worker? He is serving or he speaks, only speaks or he serves? Even his disciples ask him to take rest. He told that, why you are putting me into rest? I do not want. I want to work. So now I am also seeing many people who are offending. That's why we are not happy. Don't try to find faults with anyone. Coming to the class and speaking over phone, not entering there. So it means that they neglect this one, temple. They are enjoying the material world as though they are closer to temple. You understand my point? As though there are so many Vaishnavas present here and the host is missing. He wants to enjoy materially. He doesn't want to respond for the devotees here. Is it offense or not? Offense or not? So for your son Pritham also, please teach this one. So his future is not going to be happy. Please, this is my duty to tell. Yesterday I was telling even in my class that Brahma was speaking to Narada. What the time he was speaking? He was speaking in present tense or past tense or future tense? At the present time, Brahma is speaking to Narada. What he was speaking about? The past or future? Future. What is going to happen? That Brahma is giving the knowledge to Narada. How Brahma knows? Brahma knows Krishna thoroughly, fully. So a Vaishnava, a Guru also knows fully. That's why he is stopping the persons, those who are committing mistakes. That's why Guru is heavy. Just an ordinary mother, innocent mother, ignorant mother, doesn't allow her child to touch fire. Isn't it? She knows the future. Simple, ordinary, uneducated lady, she knows the future to some extent. So one who is fully Krishna conscious, he cannot direct you for your good future. Please understand this one. How we are suffering. We are unknowingly, we are committing so many mistakes. Thinking that I am very well fitted into this temple, there is no problem for me. The same thing even Arjuna was also thinking, Bhima was also thinking. But they developed a false ego, pride. But Krishna curbed them also. So we are also thinking, I am initiated, I am Krishna, I am this, I am that, 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 that. I am not gone till now. Whenever we use I am, we are under the influence of three modes. Isn't it? So, even English people, they say, work while you work, play while you play. That's the way to be happy and gay, isn't it? But why we are not like that one? Why we are not attentive in this class? Why we are? One fellow is telling, I want to see my uncle. At the time of taking class on Sunday, everyone knows, Sunday evening. How many people can give importance for the class? Is number one, Krishna conscious person. No class, okay, later that go, but I have to see my uncle, it's very, very important. Isn't it? If one person has some opportunity and he neglects that one, what is the reaction for that one? It's good or bad? One has the golden opportunity to render service to Krishna and he misses that one. What the reaction of for that person?
He will not get a chance.
No? Are you
saying that? He will never get that chance. He will never get it again.
Only that much? He will suffer or he will enjoy? So please understand, anyone, if the class starts at 5 o'clock, I will come only 7 o'clock. Is good or bad? This and all, so many problems, so many mistakes we are committing. If a person enters Krishna conscious movement, he should be
sincere,
enthusiastic, utshaha. Nikshaya, dhairyat. Ukshaha, enthusiastic. Nikshaya, determined. Dhairyat.
Patient.
Dhairyat.
Patience.
Patience. One day I am going to become? devotee, pure devotee. For that one, what we have to do? We have to become austere, sacrifice our life. Recently I read the thing, earlier I read only Bhakti Siddhanta Maharaj used to tell that we have to sacrifice some gallons of blood to make a person devotee. Recently I read Prabhupada's purport that one has to sacrifice some buckets of blood. Some buckets of blood to make a devotee. So we should understand, just like infinitive, we see no infinitive. Is that any value? Can anyone tell exactly what is infinitive? Infinite level 1, infinity level 2, we can go. Infinitive is uncountable. Like that, some people with just by one word you can understand. Some people they want more time, some people want. Brahma, he understood this knowledge through how many verses?
4 verses.
So, this Arjuna, he understood with
700.
And Parikshit Maharaj, Srimad Bhagavatam, 18,000. Please understand, they are different. So how many of you want how many verses? Just think of yourself. But our time is limited. One day we are going to die, give up our body. Isn't it? Now all are over 30, isn't it? No one is less than 30. 7 or 2. Average. So we have to understand why we are as though in ISKCON, Krishna conscious movement, I am suffering. Very first thing everyone tells, the definition of a intelligent person. Who is intelligent? You never heard this one? Any class no one taught you? Why I am suffering? But still I am suffering. As though I have been in this moment for more than 10 years. I am in the initial stage only. I am where I was. Isn't it? Please understand what we are doing. If that is not pleasing Krishna, then that action is going to give us horrible reaction. How we can think that Krishna is happy with our action? Now the question comes, how we can think that Krishna is happy with this my action? Who am I? Soul. So how the soul, the part and parcel of Krishna, can please the whole Krishna? How it can? That's very, very difficult. Following others, the envy doesn't allow. One bottle is there.
By helping the other bottle.
How you can help? You first of all you help yourself. Then only you can help others. How you can help yourself? Many are chanting. See, I'm giving the example, one bottle is there. It should become perfect bottle for milk. It should contain fully milk. I'm pouring that milk. The bottle becomes full. I'm putting the lid. Then that bottle is okay. Isn't it? So you are the soul. Okay? Krishna is the source, the whole. How you can understand that my action, this particular action is satisfying Krishna? That's not impossible, Prabhu. That's not impossible. How many times, huh? You have seen Krishna's hidden hand? When you see Krishna's hidden hand, you never commit mistake. You never misunderstand. You never become envy. You never develop your false ego. You have no contamination at all. That is seeing Krishna in that particular event. The person is pleasing the whole, the part and parcel is pleasing the whole. What is the soul? What is the soul? The bottle has the capacity, isn't it? It is a hollow bottle. Bottom is closed, so I can pour, it can withstand that one. So the bottle contains vacuum place. It has the capacity to hold milk. So what is the soul? I'm removing the skin of the banana and feeding you, but you are not eating. The bottle has the capacity. Eternal. Something is telling. It's really, I'm telling of all you, only this service is little intelligent. Really, I'm telling. I tested many, many times. It's telling eternity. Can anyone have to tell what is the soul? Feeling, willing,
thinking.
Sat, Chit, Anand. Feeling is the activities. Sat, Chit, Anandam, that is, you are going to benefit that one. Prayojana. Feeling. Any event you are feeling Krishna. Willing. What is the willing? You will to please Krishna. Thinking Krishna. Feeling Krishna, thinking Krishna, willing Krishna. That is the soul's saturation point. When the soul comes to that saturation point, you are actually getting the benefit of eternity, full knowledge and blissfulness. Satya Chitta Ananda. That time Krishna is pleased. How a soul, the child fully surrenders to Krishna, fully surrenders to the mother or father, then the child is happy. Parents are happy. Isn't it? Prahlada never surrenders to his father. So father is not happy. But Prahlada is happy. Why? Prahlada is on the right. Is feeling, willing, thinking all of Krishna. That's why he is completely satisfied. Hiranyakashipu, thinking, feeling, willing, everything, self. Isn't it? That's why he could not come to the level of Satya Chitta Ananda. So even Krishna is not happy. Now you can understand whether you want to be like Hiranyakashipu or Prahlada. You understand the point? How a soul can please the whole? This is the attack. We have this. We feel, we will, we think. All these things. This is called Trikarana Suddhi. Kayena Vacha, Manasendrayeva, Buddhyatmanava, Prakrutai Swabhava, Swabhava. That is our self, self-characters. Karomi Yajyat Sakalam Parasmai Narayana Yajyat Samarpayami. So this is the way. If we are deviating slightly from that point, we are offenders. If we are not following the instructions, we are offenders. After acquiring the instructions, we are not following that, that is also offense. Why Prabhupada suffered so long for 33 years in India? Isn't it? He tried. He wanted to help the family members. This is not the intention of Prabhupada, this is which Krishna's intention to teach all of us the lessons from the life of Prabhupada. When Prabhupada completely neglected the family, because the family completely neglected him, till then he was bearing them, tolerating them. Once they told not necessary, then only he told, okay, I am not with you. That time, you see, he never suffered. He doesn't have money, he doesn't have any known persons, he doesn't have even ticket, but all the things, what all the difficulties he had, everything is met. Isn't it? When he come to fully Krishna consciousness. Isn't it? As though the sponsor, Maharaj Desai, Mrs. Maharaj Desai, she was reluctant to give the ticket, but still he convinced her. From negative point to he come to the positive point. So she has given. So this way we should understand that without becoming proud of ourselves, without becoming envious of anyone else, we should try to please Krishna. We should not have any self-motivations. Then you see, Krishna will act through you. We need not act. Krishna is the doer. We are all instruments only. That's why we are unable to see Krishna. The boy is lifting the weight. Behind the trunk, behind him, the father is there. That we can be able to see. The boy is telling, I only lifted, mother. He's calling very happily, mother, mother, see, I lifted. But this is material. Now we can be able to see, but spiritually, our eyes are not oriented. That's why we are unable to see Krishna, what Krishna is doing. But in fact, everything is done by Krishna. Even what I am speaking, I never prepared anything. Please understand, I want to take only the topic that yesterday event happened. The yesterday's event made me to fix this topic, today's topic. You understand? Why you are all? Many people can think, calling is coming, office. You come immediately. Why it is coming? Why Krishna is making him to call him? Everything is done by Krishna. Try not to offend any devotee. Particularly Guru. Guru Ninda. Guru Aparada. Anyone thinks something negative of your Guru, your life is miserable. Please understand this one. With your Guru, you cannot deal any material actions, only spiritual. You cannot deal with material activities, only spiritual, and only it's nice. Otherwise we have to suffer. You can expect only spiritual instructions from your Guru. Don't expect any material benefits from your Guru. That is offense again. So this way we should understand. I am going to the class means I should turn off my cell phone. I do not want to take any risk. I do not want to make Krishna displeased. Otherwise, you are hearing the class, some call comes, many people take the cell phone and go out. It means that you are giving importance for your call, not for Krishna Katha. Is it offensive or not? Please understand that. Obviously we are all doing that one. Invariably we are doing like that one. But we are not understanding the significance of the class. Krishna is testing. I will test this person. Whether he is a good listener, he is going to hear me or he is going to hear his friend. Isn't it? So the action what we are doing, what we are feeling, willing, thinking, there should be only to please Krishna. Then only Krishna is pleased. Patram pushpam palam toyam yeme bhaktya. The devotion comes when you are feeling, willing, thinking is of Krishna. Then only that is called bhakti. You are not expecting anything else. So this is the soul. When we are acting on the soul platform means, whatever be the thing we are feeling, willing, thinking, that should be of Krishna, then we will become Sattva Chitta Ananda. You understand? In second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, the activities are not mentioned. Only the characters, properties, only the properties are mentioned. So we should not get confused with this one. But we know Sattva Chitta Ananda, how to come to that one? We do not know feeling, willing, thinking. We are feeling something else, how I be happy. The knowledge of how I can get so much money, wealth, this, that and all. Willing, I want to become controller of everything. I want to be like this one, I want to be like that one. Mostly, if a person, if not doing the positive things and avoid negative things, then he can advance also. Advancement comes when there is no negativities. Then only we can train advancement. In algebra, you know, plus, origin, minus. Minus 10 to minus 9 you are coming, that is also advancement. Isn't it? Minus 10 to minus 9 you approach, that is also advancement. But that advancement is positive, still negative. Isn't it? Suppose you are going from 3 to 4, that is also advancement. But that is positive. Isn't it? So we are all in infinitive negative. From there we have at least to come to origin. Then only we will get plus positives. So please understand how best I can come to positive happiness. How can I purify myself? If I don't offend anyone, then Krishna is pleased the most. So preachers are the most beloved devotees for Krishna. It means that the preacher, how he should be, without having any discrimination, he should bring out boldly truth. He cannot hide anything. He has to open. Because he knows paradukkha dukkhi. He should be paradukkha dukkhi. Why he should be paradukkha dukkhi? They are going on the wrong way. They are going to face the problems. I don't want him to suffer. That is paradukkha dukkhi. It is not that one, a person having no job, how I can get him job? That is not paradukkha dukkhi. Isn't it? Even Krishna stops a devotee who is putting wrong step, isn't it? That is his special mercy. So, if we try to avoid offending particularly devotees, and then the most gurus, we cannot offend gurus. If even if it seems that guru is wrong, you cannot think that he is wrong. Think that I do not understand him. That is the main point. We cannot say my guru is wrong. But you can put me a question that why this Bali Maharaj, he found fault with this guru. Then we have to compare. What is the comparison? What is the comparison? Sadhu Shastra Guru Vakya Chitate Karyaikha. So Guru is telling that he is Vishnu, he is going to take away everything. Then we have to come to the road. So better not to give charity. So this the scriptures are telling. So the Guru is telling like that one. So he neglected the Guru. Isn't it? Such a Guru is not real Guru, they are the fake Guru. Misleading Guru. Isn't it? So for a genuine Guru, we cannot do any offense. So please understand. If you do, the reaction is horrible. So like that one, we can advance. The trick for advancing is, if you don't find faults with anyone and try to glorify a person who is fully faulty, then also we can advance. Don't see all the unwanted things. See what is very important in that person. Isn't it? Then we can advance fast. This is the tricks. But don't think that the Guru should not find faults with anyone. If he doesn't find faults, how he can go to correct him? Isn't it? That is the duty. Everyone karmanya vadikaraste. What is your position? According to the position, what is the prescribed duty you have to do? You understand? Not find faults. Prabhupada used to tell, what is the word he used? Rascal, no? So if he doesn't see the fault, why is he going to tell that rascal word? So he got the right to call like that. You understand? You have to do your duty. That's why the preacher should come boldly. He has to, he cannot hide. If he hides, then he cannot be a good. He cannot rectify the person. He is going to become worse. So he had to rectify that one. So there are so many ways we are offending. If you want to be advanced, you want advanced means be thorough in the class. Whether that is encouraging, enthusiastic or not, be there for the pleasure of Krishna. You are very enthused, you are very, very interesting. Class is interesting, you are dealing, you are enjoying. And Krishna, seeing that, for his own pleasure he is enjoying, the person, he doesn't understand anything. But he is tolerating. He is sitting, humbly he is sitting. Then how Krishna will feel him? Feel him bad or good? That's why Prabhupada used to tell, even if you don't understand, sit, be seated. Tolerate. You just hear the words. Whether you understand the words or not, no problem. You just hear. The words are going to purify you. Huh? The grandfather asking the grandson to take this basket, which was filled with the coal. Bring water from the river. He thought, what is the fool grandfather I have? From the basket, how can I carry water? He never asked the question. He carried the instruction. He brought. He got drenched also. He never bothered for that one. Isn't it? Without having any knowledge, the basket got purified. So without nothing, because the words are having the potency of Krishna. Isn't it? The potency of Krishna is going to purify us. So this way, we should be very, very attentive, completely absorbed. The complete absorption is very, very important. To the extent you surrender to Krishna, that extent you give a reward. So off way means no good. Off knowledge is always dangerous. Off way you are here, off way you are out. That's no good. Try to see Krishna in each and every one. Can you be able to find faults with such a person? If one person is there, is neglecting all Vaishnavas, then I see him, he's doing some, he's behaving mistakenly. If I'm seeing him, Krishna, within him, how I can chastise him? If I chastise him, if I beat him, even Krishna will also feel beatings. How, what my action should be towards him? How to help him? Why to help him? Give that one. Where is it?
Try to make him understand that.
What he should understand? What he should understand?
That his activities are pleasing Krishna.
My activity is good. That's why I'm acting like this one. That is giving me pleasure. Why you are disturbing my pleasure? Is there an answer for you or not? I don't want to waste time. Is there any answer for you? You are telling, I am very happy. Why you are disturbing me? Then what you answer? Make him understand that he is not he. He is part and parcel of Krishna. Being part and parcel of Krishna, he is supposed not to behave as he is behaving. You have to first of all convince him that he is part and parcel of Krishna. How you can convince? He is acting so far, but he is not happy. He's trying, he's changing his plans. But still he's not happy. So we had to interrupt that point. You see, you have been trying, you are not successful. The truth is, you are not you. You are thinking your body, think your soul. You are seeing so many dead bodies going to graveyards daily. We are souls. Souls are part and parcel of Krishna. If you accept this one, you will never suffer. This way we have to convince him. So, being part and parcel of Krishna, what your present behavior is not suitable. You have to change your behavior. You understand? This is the way. First of all, we have to make him understand that is part and parcel of Krishna. That's why anything that he was doing, he has been doing that one for a long time, he was not happy. Now we have to make him convinced. Huh? Then we have to tell the solution. Isn't it? In this way, even if we find faults with anyone, we should not expose him, but we have to convince him that he is on wrong path. You understand? In that way, we are not finding faults with him. If you make him understand that he is suffering, then we are not finding faults with him. We are giving the reason. We are convincing him. Isn't it? You do like this one, you will never get any activity which are against the principles of Krishna consciousness. You understand? So many unwanted engagements are there now. That are not because we are not thoroughly understood Krishna consciousness. We are not thoroughly engaged in the service of Krishna. That's why this disturbance is involved. You understand? So this way try to advance. Then you can see that for your Krishna conscious service, no disturbance will be there, external disturbance. For this you have to do very nice sadhana and then follow all the principles till you can be able to see Krishna's hidden hand in each and everything, everyone, every event. Then there is no problem for you. This is the way. This is Krishna consciousness. This is the way to avoid offending others. And then you can be able to avoid sufferings. We can come to Satya Chitta Ananda. How we can come to Satya Chitta Ananda position? Thinking, feeling, willing only about Krishna. Any action. I am taking a class. In that class, I feel something, I will something, I think something. If all these three is not of Krishna, then I will never become Satchitananda. Isn't it? I will have some fear. Satya means eternity. I have some fear. What the fear? If Pakistan comes and puts a bomb here in Chennai, what will happen to me? I'm taking class. If Pakistan comes straight to Chennai, that too, you know, Chennai, and this tsunami, Kolhapur tsunami, and puts a bomb, what will happen to me? That fear will not have. Knowledge. Why I'm suffering? What precaution I should take? What action I should take? Not necessarily. If Krishna is there, means nothing. Cowboys, Gopas and all, they are going and enter into the mouth of Agasura. No problem. Isn't it? They want to please Krishna. So that is blissfulness. This is all very, very important. In the initial, we have to practice three things: feeling, willing, thinking. That boost up. The final saturation point comes to Sat, Chit, Ananda. In that position we are in our constitutional position, there is no problem, no external problem, no internal problem. No? 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 Tapatraya. So this is the way to understand what is Krishna consciousness. So this is not the words. Words to begin with, the final one is actions. Krishna consciousness means actions. It is not only keep speaking. Some people they only speak. Their activities and all not good. They are not accepting many responsibilities. Krishna gives some, each person got the responsibility. They don't accept the responsibility. They only keep telling. I'm telling you are not doing, what can I do? But he doesn't know. How to make him to do that one, he doesn't know. He can only speak, isn't it? I can tell that one. No, I'm telling, but you are not accepting. What can I do? So that is not pleasing Krishna. If I can make him to accept and do that one, then Krishna is pleased. You understand my point? It means that I'm lacking how to engage him. I'm lacking, I'm only giving instruction. Do this. But I do not know how to make him, so there is some shortcoming within me. Isn't it? That one is obstructing Krishna to get pleased. So it's not that much easy. I did my MBA, I can give class. We should have some realization. How best I can convince, how best I can give love of God to them so that they can accept that one. I give, you don't accept, what can I do? Again you have to come back to this material world to learn something more. That's not complete. Okay? Krishna consciousness is complete and perfect. Completely perfect and perfectly complete. So this way I hope all of you can understand something and put into practice. And try to see Krishna in everyone, everything, every event, everywhere. Then Krishna will help all of us. Okay? Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. If you have any question, please. One by one. Yes.
Prabhu, you told that in the case of Bali Maharaj, Sukdracharya told that his Vishnu don't give him the
charity,
he will put you in the road. In this case, Bali Maharaj is know that he knows the Shastra that we should always
please Vishnu.
But in some cases, like Bali Maharaj, many of the people and even ourselves, we are not knowing that what is the main
purpose. Scriptures.
At that time, we are following blindly whatever the Guru is saying. So, how should we correct that one?
Your question itself utterly wrong. You have to acquire the knowledge from the books of Prabhupada. Prabhupada books are scriptures for 10,000 more years. Before accepting any guru, you should go through Prabhupada books. You should understand. That's why we are telling, follow the formula, Sadhu Shastra Guru Vakya. Krishna, Prabhupada is telling, don't believe anyone blindly. First place he is telling this one. In second place he is telling, follow Sadhu Shastra Guru Vakya. These two instructions are very, very important. Any person. Don't think that Parameshwar Das is like this, he's speaking like that. Let me listen to him, anything and everything. I need not read Prabhupada books. That is your wrong conception. First of all, you have to read Prabhupada books. That's why we call him as the founder Acharya. If Parameswar Das tells something against the teachings of Prabhupada, then you can discard, you can neglect Parameswar Das. There is nothing wrong. You are correct. You are just like Prahlada. Prahlada, he negated his gurus. He negated his, the words of his father. That is the thing. But we are not like, we are not reading Prabhupada. And we have some fear. If I don't accept this Maharaj, what will happen to me? Prahlada never thought. He never thought that if I neglect my guru, what will happen to me? You know, Prahlada never thought. But you are reciting the story so many times and you don't have that boldness of Prahlada. Anyone can boldly ask any Guru Maharaj, can you show me in an end of Krishna? Is there anyone asked like that one? So we are not like Prahlada, as though we know the story of Prahlada. We understand. So first of all, we have to read the books of Prabhupada and acquire the knowledge. Then you have to compare, you have to see. Bhagavad Gita is giving the knowledge. And this Bhagavatam is the giving the explanation how the devotees, they led their life using these principles. So these two are very, very important. One is theory. Bhagavad Gita is the theory. Bhagavatam is the realized souls. And we have to realize that one by reading Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chaitanya Charitamrita is just know it happened. So that gives more inspirations. So this way, don't get fooled. You are just blindly following a person means you are a fool, number one. Don't do. You read Prabhupada books. Okay? Next, someone. You got the answer for your question? Don't fool yourself, sir.
This Sachitananda means, coming to the prema, it means prema lover. Is that means? Love of Godhead. One who comes to the Sachitananda level.
Yes, yes, that is the love of God. Complete one. If Krishna, you can love someone, that is very easy. But others loving you is very, very difficult. Isn't it? Normally, you like someone, you can love him. But that particular person need not love you. Isn't it? So Krishna, you can love Krishna. But it doesn't mean that Krishna has to love you. You come to your constitution person Sachidananda, then Krishna obviously loves you. That is the love of God. In love of God, you are not going to find any faults with anyone. You are going to help him, everyone. You don't discriminate even persons. That is the love of God. The rest and all lust. I lust you, you lust me, let us marry. It is not I love you, you love me. That is the useless words. That is misnomer. There is no love with anyone. There is no love with material. There is no love with anything that belongs to this material world. You can love only with those things come from spiritual world. That's why there is no difference between the person and his holy name. Krishna and person, Krishna, there is no difference. You can love the holy names and you can keep on chanting also. You can love the deities and you can serve him very nicely also. But it is impossible to love any person, those who are on the level of the body. Today they are marrying, yesterday they are divorcing. Where is the love? That is only lust. No. If you keep Krishna in between two lovers, the two lovers, they keep Krishna in the center, then they love the lust. Otherwise, that transforms to lust. So this is the love. Love is only, belongs to spiritual world, not this world. This is Dukkalayam now. In Dukkha, can anyone love? No. Yes. Correct. Okay. Let him.
Sadhu, Shastra, Guru, Vakya. Guru, what is telling should match with Shastra.
In the Shastra and Sadhu also. Sadhu means those who left their body, those who led their lives according to the scriptural injection and they left their body.
So it is action. Sadhu's action should
their
match
lives.
With...
Lives their means actions. Action. How they led their lives. Yes.
Yes. Offenses are done by devotees, some devotees, initial devotees, and they are going through the sufferings. After sufferings, that offenses are nullified. The how they are nullified? Because of sufferings, they will nullify, or they have to do more service to nullify that offense.
Why there are sufferings?
Because of offense, they are suffering.
Why Krishna is giving that foolishly? Why Krishna is giving them sufferings? You should understand that one. Because you did this one, that's why I'm slapping on your cheek. Huh? That's good. If I slap on your cheek, there should be some lesson I'm giving you. I'm giving siksha. Siksha means two things. I'm punishing you and I am I'm giving you knowledge also. That should be two things. That is only the real siksha. So you offend something. You are suffering. In that point, what you are learning? Punishment is there, you understood punishment. I did some mistake, that's why. What is the lesson you are learning from that?
I should not do that same.
I cannot repeat that one. I cannot offend anyone. The lesson you should learn. Huh? Isn't it? You
so
got the answer?
I got the answer. So till that, Krishna will impart that knowledge, then the suffering will go. So I have to learn.
Till you realize he will he will beat on your head, pounce on your head, till you understand that one. Once you understand and you surrender, then Krishna is not going to force anything over your head. That's the point.
One more question.
Yes.
Initially when I started preaching, there were small devotees. Small
less,
number of devotees.
Less number of devotees.
I was able to connect to them very clearly. But the day goes now, the strength is increased. New people are coming. We are doing bhajans. We are following the approach. First Hare Krishna, then Vaishnava song. Radha Krishna Singh.
So you cannot give that.
We are not connected.
Very good, very good.
What is the problem?
Wrong is within you. As long as you think that you are the doer, it's very, very difficult for you to meet all the demands. In my class, anyone can complain that I am not meeting all of you? Anyone is there like that one? I am not meeting you, all of you. Then, as long as you think that you are taking care of them, you will find this type of problems. If Krishna is helping all these people through me, then it is possible. Oh Krishna, I am unable to take care of all these people. Why you are sending these many people? Is the way to think a preacher? The preacher should always think, how best Krishna, you are going to engage me in your service to help all this audience. That should be yours. I cannot control. Like this managers and all tell you, Guru, you don't interfere in the management. You do not know. They are boldly telling. Guru has to come and give a class and go off. Don't interfere in our affairs. What is this? Is Krishna consciousness or your consciousness? Everything is done by Krishna. Maya adhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharachara. As long as we think that I am the best person, gone. You are no more Krishna conscious. just depend upon Krishna and do, then you will see more and more people turn out. Okay? Anyone else? Anything else? Yes? Okay.
We should not find fault with others. We see some other person is doing some mistake. Then would you advise or with?
You have to convince him that he is not what he is thinking. He is the soul, part and parcel of Krishna. But he is not thinking like that one. He is thinking that he is his body. For his body he is doing any action and every action. So that is wrong.
We have
to tell that one, he is trying for his pleasure for a long time, but he is not getting the pleasure. So he is thinking something wrong. Now you correct him. You are not your body, you are the soul. Now you just try to help your soul, then you will be happy. This is the thing.
If so, aged person also, we should means more age means
elder or anything is no problem. Elder for only the material body.
Okay.
We are telling them we are not the body, sir. The body by age means there is no one can tell that the soul is older than me. Souls and all exist from the beginning of the time. When Krishna is there, that time only the all parts and parcels are all existing. So no soul can tell that when I am older than you. But my body is older than you, that we can say. But comparing the souls, you are elder, I am younger, that's nothing like that one. Souls and all existing at the same time. All the souls. There is no older and younger and new and no old and all. There is no creation of souls now. It's not like that one. Everything is existing from the time immemorial. So no one can tell I am older than you. It means that he is referring to the material body. He doesn't have the idea for the soul. Okay?
Some person, so much disease, they cannot tolerate. And
they cannot tolerate means you don't have that much power to convince him, first point. Second one, he doesn't want to accept that one. So problems are with both. Okay? Now you have to pray only Krishna.
So due to that, they also make suicide and also accident people. Whether they are again going to get next body or
accident, those who die.
Accidentally means.
Okay. Because of the accident, all that is due to the old karma.
Okay.
They will get to next birth. The time of the birth, what they think of, the status, the same status they are going to be in the next life.
But by pain they cannot tolerate and suicide, they get next body.
Parents?
Some person they cannot tolerate because there are so many diseases. Many diseases. They cannot tolerate.
Okay.
They make suicide. That time after.
No. If they commit suicide, they don't get next birth. They don't get this body, material body again. They have to be like ghost. They cannot get. But they should surrender to Krishna. Krishna, I cannot tolerate this body because I did so much sinful actions. Because of that I am suffering, I understand. Please forgive me. Please help me. Now I understand that I am supposed to serve you. I will serve you. Please help me. This is the solution, but not committing suicide. One commits suicide, he cannot get this material body easily. You understand? But they can hear. If the satsang is going on, if any ghost is here, if the ghost hear that one, if the ghost become purified, then it will get next body, material body, otherwise not. So anybody else?
Can a guru
identify his devotee, that how much apparat he is having and give him. Guru is also like a doctor. His devotee is how much apparat he has. He can by seeing him as the disciple, by seeing him, he can identify and tell him the so much you have or like that person, that devotee must be thinking he doesn't have any, but the guru can identify and tell him.
Yeah.
So.
Can he identify?
Can he identify and tell so much apparat?
That's the thing, we are giving the instructions now. What is the instruction? Instructions means you are deviating from the scriptural injunctions. So you have to rectify your mistake. Keep on rectifying the instructions. One day you are going to become pure. The extent of that one you cannot say. All the offenses you cannot commit at the same time. As you are acting, the Guru watches you and he will instruct you. It will take some time. It is not all of a sudden that you are going to become 100% pure. That's not possible. Then also it's possible if you can accept anything and everything for only Krishna's pleasure. You are willing, feeling, thinking, everything is only for Krishna. Right now if you do that one, then also you are completely purified. Mamchayo vyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevita sagunan samiti tethan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. If you completely think of Krishna, you are in spiritual platform. You can easily come out from the influence of maya. Sagunan samiti tethan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. You are in that transcendental mode. So that depends upon your interest, your determination, your enthusiasm. So it is not that one, we can all of a sudden, we can purify that one. How much you are interested, how much you can tolerate, that depends. Anyone else? Then,
Hare Krishna.
Yes.
For my friend, one Mataji is taking children's class.
Children's class.
4 months before, starting the children's class. But nearby, the Muslims people is not there. Jealous to Mataji children. When the day before, after, the children's are more.
The children are?
Children are increasing.
Okay, the strength is increasing.
That's why the Mataji, for Muslim people, Muslim...
Envious.
The Mataji is, mind is so fear. Because Muslim people jealous to the Bhagavad Gita class. How can this rectify the...
The Mataji is taking class?
Yeah, Mataji taking class.
Then she will face her own. If she takes the class with the help of Krishna, as long as the Mataji thinks I am taking class, now my neighbors and are Muslims, they become envious of me, how can I take care of? Then she has to face the problems. If she depends upon Krishna, Krishna, Muslims also your children, these people with me also your children, and you are using me as an instrument. Krishna's single action going to please different desires of different people. If I think that my action, that need not satisfy even single soul of anyone. So the thing, that problem with all the preachers is they consider themselves that they are the preacher, they are doing everything. As long as they think that they are the doers, they cannot meet all the demands, all the problems. That's absolutely wrong. That is not Krishna consciousness. They cannot think that I can take class, I can give answer. That's not possible. We are unable to even lift an insignificant blade of grass from the floor. That is our capacity. I'm lifting because Krishna's help. And why the preachers? They are preaching just like the blindly. For their name, fame, prestige, they should preach without depending upon the mercy of Krishna. You understand or not my point? That's why Guru is always heavier. Many people that turn even against him. Many people are like that. But we don't bother. We have to tell openly, boldly. Cannot hide also. Mistake never lies outside. Muslims are not wrong. The preacher, the Mataji is wrong. The Muslims are helping the Mataji. Just depend upon Krishna. Don't show your capacity, your intelligence to us. No one can win our intelligence except Krishna. The Muslims are teaching her. She's not understanding. You got my point, Mataji? Each and everyone should become like this. Sir. We are unable to do. We are desperately. We are helpless. Even with Krishna's help only, we are breathing, we are speaking, we are drinking, we are speaking. The person in Bhagavad Gita, in one of the slokas, is told that one becomes Krishna conscious fully as though he is acting, he is breathing, he is doing something, he feels that he is not doing anything. Suppose the wind blowing. Very forcibly. All the windows, if you keep open that one, the windows and all, they move. Isn't it? And we are within this building. As the windows are moving, we don't feel that we are moving. This I am Atma-like. This is my body. My body is all the doors, windows and all moving. But I never feel that I am moving. This is the soul. You understand? And we are all having popular with the pride. False ego. I am taking class. They have become envious of me. How you can tell, a preacher can tell, they become envious of me? I am so talented a person or what? So first of all, we should purify ourselves. We are not the doers. Even Krishna cannot help them. Isn't it? Actually, the Muslims are helping her. I told even in my own case, when I come to my home here, first of all, here is the Amankot temple. Two temples are there, one church is there. So much noise, so much things. I unable to, this one, here, chant my chant, this and that. Then afterwards, everything gone. One day I told that I spoke to even Christ. Isn't it? You know that one? You heard that one? I spoke to Christ and Christ spoke to me. Isn't it? I told Christ, my dear Christ, your so-called followers, they are disturbing this much. Do you want me to get disturbed like this one? So Christ told, I am fulfilling their desires. Then I told, you may fulfill the desires of your followers, but I am disturbed. Then he told, these people, those who are glorifying me, they themselves crucified me. Once upon a time, they crucified. He showed me even the nails, you believe it or not. He took the nail and then they put the nails in my hand, feet and all. How much I tolerated, you know? because I tolerated that much, today they are worshipping me. They crucified me that day, today they are worshipping me. Don't you want to become like me? He questioned me. He questioned me. I told, yes, my dear Christ, I want to be like you. Since then, as though they have so much sound, I'm not at all disturbed. You believe me? I'm not. This is the truth. Please don't think anyone that we are the doers. We are getting puffed up that way. We are all children. Whether we are Muslims or Christians or Jews or Zoroastrians or anyone, no problem. We are all human beings. We are all living entities. We are all children of Krishna. This very, very nice knowledge we have been given by Prabhupada. Before that also I read so many books. That's not giving like that one. Because of Prabhupada, Prabhupada surrender. Prabhupada coming in this parampara. This is actually I experienced. So no one should get puffed up with that. We are the doers. I am doing. That's not the real. Krishna is the doer. We are all his instruments. Okay? Just explain her. Before becoming one post, before occupying one post, we should learn the definition of that post. The qualities what we should supposed to acquire before occupying that post. Then only the post is not going to give you any problem. Without qualifications, if you occupy that post, that is going to create problems to you. Am I correct or not? Please understand this one. Okay? Is that answer for your question? So anyone else? Anything else? Okay, that's it. Yes, continue, no problem.
That it's told in Bhagavatam that a steel-framed heart.
Steel-framed heart, yes.
Means, when they chant, we don't get tears, that means we steel-framed heart.
Yeah.
That sentiment, see, when there are two classifications. In the question and also when they get initiation, question also, are you Vedantist? Are more sentimentalist, something like
you are
Vedantist philosophy,
okay,
or more towards sentiments. Okay, because we are learning more philosophy, that everything,
yes, all your sentiments should go off. You cannot have any sentiment, then only you are purified.
But there are tears also, sentiment tears.
Why the tears comes?
Because of love.
And otherwise, if I slapped on your cheek, then tears will not come?
Tears will come.
But both tears come. But is there any difference in the tears?
One is cold, other is hot.
Which is colder? You are correct. One is hot and one is cold. Anyone can tell when that is hot? Happy means? Cool. Correct. Angry means? It's a heart. Same tears, please understand. Same tears, same person, same thing. But there is the difference in qualities. So what is your question?
The question is, so we are learning both Bhagavad Gita, Bhavadam, knowledge, everything. But the sentiment, we are not learning actually. Means how to acquire the sentiment.
What do you understand by sentiment?
Tears comes, have goes, or believe the...
No. Your sentiment means what?
Sometimes.
Your behavior, your character, that is sentiment. Your sentiment and my sentiment. The way in which you behave, the way in which you think, the way in which you feel, that are all your sentiments. A pure devotee's sentiment is thinking of Krishna, feeling of Krishna, willing of Krishna. Another pure devotee's sentiment is thinking of Krishna, feeling of Krishna, willing of Krishna. both pure devotees, sentiments are the same. You are materialists. You are feeling different, willing different, thinking different. Another materialist, his feeling is different, willing is different, thinking is different. That's why you both will clash. We should come out from that sentiments. So pure devotees, they don't call that as the sentiments. Sentiment is only that belongs to one particular person. So if you come to the platform of spirituality, then there is no clarification. There is no clash at all. No conflict. All the same. Ekehe Kurunandana. Okay? Yes?
Also, we learn that suffering is mercy of Krishna. So, whenever there is suffering, we should treat that as it's Krishna's arrangement for me to understand something.
But something my mistakes.
So, how do we understand whether suffering is due to differences that we did or the suffering is actually arrangement? Because even apparently we see that Pandavas also suffered. Kunti Devi also suffered. So we cannot point to say that.
So they are also suffered. There is no difference between me and them.
So
that's the final thing.
You know, how I understand that, because I committed some offenses that I undergo the suffering, or whether it is for Krishna's arrangement that I should bear the suffering for somebody else to learn that. I have to undergo the suffering. I set an example to somebody.
I understand your point that you do not know the suffering for yours. That is whether for your actions or that is only Krishna intentionally giving you to teach others. This is your question. Isn't it? So you have to understand that if you can be able to see Krishna in all your circumstances. You are pure devotee then. Then there is no action. There is no reaction for you. Even we can eat meat and preach if nothing is available except meat. That's not offensive. Isn't it? The pure devotees, they don't find meat as fair, meat as meat. They see only Krishna even in meat. In that situation, if you come to the situation, in all you see only Krishna, then Krishna thinks he is best instrument for me. I can use this instrument. Isn't it? I can teach many, many people using this instrument. You understand? You never feel that you are suffering the time. How many times Pandavas, they brought complaints to Krishna that why we are suffering? Is there any instance? Have they brought any complaint to Krishna? Because they always think of Krishna. They never felt the sufferings as sufferings. Isn't it? Just like Krishna took Arjuna and put him in a miserable condition, the worst condition. What? Where from you got these impurities? He spoke like that. It is not reaction. He understood this is only Krishna using me as an instrument to teach others. Isn't it? But for that action you feel that you are suffering, then really that is not an instrumental action. That is your previous action. You got the point? This way we should do, understand? We are all instruments. Instruments be used in three occasions, Krishna. One occasion is to fulfill the desires of all the people. Second one, to offer the reactions of all the problems, all the problems that previously they had done. That one, to help the devotees. Then also we are. To help the devotees, help all the devotees, Krishna used the Pandavas as instruments and sent him to forest. Isn't it? They never felt, they never claimed, why Krishna, we are your devotees, why you are arranging like this? They never say, they never blame. Yeah? By every instant we are blaming Krishna. What Krishna, here 20 years I am in this moment, I am chanting you, but still you are blind towards me. So this is our instrumental, or this is our previous actions. Now you can discern these two now. That's very important. Okay? You got the answer for your question?
In one of the classes also, you mentioned that while we are chanting, there is a calling bell, or
external disturbance.
There is a phone call. So that time, you mentioned that I am supposed to pause my chanting and I am supposed to attend that because it might be of some importance or some significance.
Urgency also.
Yeah, so that time I have to pause the chanting and come back from the beginning to chant. So if this is class is an extension of chanting, then when we are forced by a phone call or so
finally, what is your question?
So how should we treat that? Whether we should?
You are doing some action. You are chanting, that is one action. You are hearing the calling bell, that is one another thing, isn't it? So you have to think whether you want to do the action for yourself or you want to do something to help others. Chanting is for others or yourself? Yourself. But calling bell is ringing for others. Isn't it? He's ringing. So which is the best? Can you do your duty later on also, but you cannot get that person who is ringing the bell afterwards? Isn't it? Doing the service for yourself is better or doing the service for the other? Which is better? Isn't it? You understood the point? Everything is easy. But if you deeply understand that point. Chanting I cannot do even later on. But calling bell, the person who is the urgent person, I do not know what need he wants. And Krishna sent him. You cannot forget even where Krishna is ringing the bell. You cannot say, Krishna, why you allowed the person to give you a call? So I ought to attend him. You understand? So without seeing Krishna's hidden hand, we cannot judge anything. My service I can do every day, no problem. But it is urgency, emergency. So it is better for me to attend that front to please Krishna. Okay? This way we have to think. Okay? Okay, Hare Krishna, thank you very much. Time is also up.